Hi, I'm Stu. Welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today, I am currently constructing a social media ad for a local beer company who are housed inside what was a blacksmith's workshop. So they're kind of using that motif as a background. And as you can see, I've got layers of wood, fire, sparks, and obviously a blacksmith's clip doing his thing. And at that little cut there, from the wide to the close-up, I want to add a flash transition, but I don't want just the usual flash transition that's built into LumaFusion. I want a more controlled, bespoke flash transition. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how I do it. Okay, so let's get started. I'll zoom in a little bit, pinch and zoom. I'm going to switch off the visibility of the wood fire and the sparks just now, and we don't need to listen to the wood fire audio. Now, what you want to do is make sure that you're in between the two cuts. You're then going to work using your arrow keys I find best, but you can obviously use the just pinch, or rather hold and move option, but I just find arrow keys easier on the keyboard. And you're going to have three frames to the left, one, two, three, and then you're going to highlight clip and make a cut. Then you're going to go back to that original cut point and move three frames to the right, one, two, three, highlight that clip and make another cut. And that gives you what will be the flash transition. So you've basically got an in point and an out point, which we need to now properly set up. So if we tap on the wider shot that we want to have the flash coming in, press number 5 on the keyboard, that takes us into our color and effects. Tap on original. What you want to do is drop a keyframe at the beginning of the clip, go to the end of the clip, and at this point, you want to increase the brightness as far as you can go, decrease the contrast. Now, I quite like it at this point where I've got a little bit of detail still hanging on in there, but if you wanted to totally destroy things, then you could just totally blow out the gamma and make it white. But I actually want that little bit of detail. The last thing you're going to do, and this is what makes it a more bespoke transition, is I'm going to tap on my tint, and I'm then just going to just slide in and just start to give it a warmer look. And you don't want to be here because it'll look awful. It's very, very subtle. Just bring it in. The white shifts into a more kind of cream side of things. Best way to describe it. Then from there, we tap out. We've done the first part. So there's the first part of the flash. And then you're going to repeat things effectively, but we're going to reverse the situation. So again, highlight the second clip. Tap 5 on the keyboard again for color and effects. Tap on original. And again, just whack up the brightness, whack down the contrast, and once again, just to reiterate, if you wanted to go pure white, just adjust the gamma. I actually quite like that little bit of detail. And back into the tint, and it doesn't have to be bang on accurate that you choose the exact same sort of tone of yellow or whatever, but I just want this to kind of just slightly warm things up, not too much, like so. And then what we have to do now is we have to go to the beginning of the clip where we've got this adjustment going, tap on a keyframe, because you want this to be matching the previous flash point, and then we go to the end of the clip, and then you can just reset your sliders. So double tap brightness, double tap contrast, make sure everything else is zeroed out. Quickly go into your tint, tap white, and that then brings everything back to normal. And then if we come out, we've now got a more custom effect. So if we zoom out a little bit, and I'll play it through once without any of the extra goodies, you can see it flashes through and looks pretty good. What helps sell it is that in the wood fire foley I've got down here, if you notice that little peak of audio is basically the fire sort of spitting or crackling, and I've got that going on at the peak of the action and the actual flash transition. So if we turn that on now, and then just for sort of effect and the vibe of the whole thing, I've obviously got the fire in the corner and the sparks, because on the right hand side around about here is going to be my beer product text and things at some point. So if we play it through, then we get the custom flash transition. And at that point, I'm going to start dropping product, and there's also going to be music and things like that. That's further down the line for me to do. So there we go. One more play. Flash. So what's the difference between this and the normal flash transition? It's the fact that you control the actual length of the flash. I set it to 3 frames. You could make it tighter, 2 or 1 frame. You could alter the color somewhat, and you've just got much more flexibility with the brightness. But you see how it retains the detail at the flash point? That's the main difference. It's extremely fast and extremely subtle, but the human brain does pick up on these things. And it's like a residual memory, I think the best way to sort of put it, in the actual flash. and then that way it then continues on. So I use these a lot now. Instead of using the more traditional sort of flash transitions, it just gives my videos a more bespoke, unique look that's slightly different from other video editors. So one last play. It's done its job, as you can imagine. Product getting dropped down on the right here. And just fade to black. And there we go. A very simple transition effect that's customizable for any project. If you liked the video, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe, and get notified, all those good things. And I will catch you on the next one. See you later.